Hey guys, you're welcome to our Meat and Fact digital marketing section. And in this section, we hope to clear some myths and show you what really is involved in digital marketing and to give you more information and help you make informed decisions regarding your digital marketing. So I'm Osasu, and here with me is Felix. Our discussion for today is from some quote on Twitter.
Yeah.
From the Akomolayo, I'm going to read that here. It is regarding the just concluded election and publicity of presidential candidates. And it says, when you think about the amount of Tinubu posters, radio, and TV non-stop in Lagos, can we now make a case for how traditional advertising is dead and just a waste of money? So I brought him here because I wanted to find out that, okay, for during the election, there were posters of a particular candidate. It was everywhere in this locality, state called Lagos. And we found out that someone else got to win and who didn't get to see posters anywhere. So what we want to clear up now is, traditional advertising, does it really pay? Is it really needed? Because someone that didn't get to post billboards, banner, nothing, really get to see anything, got to win, and person that did everything did not. Mr. Felix, do you think traditional advertising is dead?
Well, I think from the Twitter user, he said something, and that's because of the outcome of things, right, based on the election, who had like more of the votes in Lagos. So he's comparing it. I'm saying this to the viewers so they get to understand what the discussion is and where we're driving to. So the person in question is Tinubu. In Lagos, for example, he lost votes in Lagos to his opponent, who is Peter Obi. So a Twitter user is trying to say that why is it that with all the old billboards, radio, TV ads, why is it that he still got to lose, or he lost to his opponent, which is Peter Obi, which comes to show that what traditional media is dead. To answer that, I would debunk that saying traditional media is dead. Although we are in the advertising space, the online space, usually we know that traditional media is fading over time. But one thing we should know is traditional media can never fade out, right? It can never what? Fade out. The only thing I think is traditional media would not have as much importance as digital marketing in general. And from what he said, Tinubu did what? Radio,
billboards,
TV, billboards, and the rest, right? So I'm sure he got to reach quite a number of audience. And it's not like people are aware, people saw it. You saw it. I saw some, right? Many of people, the viewers that stay in Lagos, they saw many of these ads. Even on the online space too, we saw it, right? But it's just the candidate you already have mindset that you'll be going for. And so that's why I think traditional media is not dead.
Okay, so as much as we say it's not dead, I disagree with you in an aspect, because we're seeing real life results, right? We're seeing real life results in the sense that most times the publicity for the opponent, Peter Obi, was through social media, was through it was the week of the election. I was seeing that him moving about some few weeks election, but mostly it was through social media. We got in publicity even without any poster and all that. And why I believe what this user is saying is because of a truth. Traditional marketing helps with visibility, but I don't think it gets the much needed results as much as digital marketing would, right? Sorry, digital space would, online space would, because now almost everybody in the urban area, based on the sample size they're using, right, have access to at least the internet to get us gain access to. And
so I would like to come in there, right, where you talked about you said the online space, people are online, and you compared the results Peter Obi got from online. You're trying to compare it with what the traditional media of Tinubu had done. Well, I would say it's quite different, because I'm going to give you an example now. So let's give two brands an example. You know of Golden Penny, right?
Yes.
So I think they are the lead in the spaghetti industry, right?
Yeah.
And I think Dangote also does spaghetti, right? Now, when you go to the market to buy spaghetti, which of the brands would you automatically go for?
Golden Penny,
right? So now imagine, up to now, Dangote gets to run marketing campaigns through traditional media, through radio, through TV, through billboard, through poster, right? Do you think it will change any fact with you moving away from Golden Penny to Dangote spaghetti?
Well, for me who likes change, if I consistently that in wherever I go, and I see an opportunity and it is played in the market, I might want to try because I've seen the brand before.
Now, don't forget that we are talking realistically now, right? We're not talking about a new brand. You know of Dangote spaghetti, right?
Yes, I do.
And you know of Golden Penny, right? Golden Penny is something which is more accepted, right? So we're not talking about a new brand. We're still on a brand you know of. So you know of Dangote, so it's not new to you, but you're still seeing more of it. So that's the question I'm asking now. Because you saw this advert on TV, radio, would you then decide that you would not buy Golden Penny and you would buy Dangote spaghetti?
Not really, I can't say that. Unless something makes me try that other one. Yes, and it's way better than the Golden Penny. Maybe that's what makes me shift my loyalty away from Golden Penny.
Okay, so how many percent of people do you think would get the Golden Penny versus the Dangote spaghetti?
More people will get the Golden Penny because Golden Penny is a brand that has steeped and stuck in the minds of people.
Okay. So from the example I gave with regards to the Golden Penny and then the Dangote spaghetti, now you'll find out that it is not about the marketing, but it is about what? The product. And the product that has gotten the heart of what? Of people. So no matter how much you promote the other brand, you promote the Dangote spaghetti, right? The heart of people are still what? Stick to what? The Golden Penny what? Spaghetti. And I feel that the only way you would go for the Dangote spaghetti is if they come up with a strategy, like giving you a discount. So if, for example, flat rate, market rate, the spaghetti are both 200 naira, right? Or Golden Penny is 200, Dangote is 190, 180. Dangote can decide, oh, buy two from us at the rate of 150, I will give you one extra. That way, we can what? Catch more what? People by giving them an incentive, a reason to what? To buy from you. But if there's no reason to buy from you, people will what? Not buy from you. Yes, another thing is that people are what? Cautious. They get to see these things, right? But they don't want to take the action to what? To go for that person. So it doesn't mean that traditional media is dead. I don't believe traditional media is dead. Traditional media still helps reach certain kind of audiences, especially the Gen X? Yeah, the Gen X audience. Yeah, the late millennials and the Gen X audience. So I still believe that traditional media can still goes a long way to help reach the right audience.
Okay, you made quite a number of points that I can agree with. But I also want to put it to you that whatever objective that the traditional media serves to achieve, online marketing achieves more. with a lower cost. And this is why, because what makes a brand sticks to the mind of its users, its repetition, constantly seeing the visuals, constantly hearing it, of which the online media also provides. And I think the only advantage that the traditional has over the online media is for people who don't have access online. And that is the only way it triumphs. But I do not think that it serves more than the purpose of what the online marketing does. This is because, one, for an online media, even for a brand that is new, I'll give you an example for a real estate brand, right? So you have them talking about the different lands, so this is this, come for inspection and all that stuff, right? It's not as if we don't see their billboards outside too, but it's just I just see it, right? I can't know whether anybody takes action to it or action for it. It just helps with visibility. But with online media, you could measure the people and you could actually see whether people took an action or not on like traditional marketing, which just there, you can't really measure as to what your content out there is able to achieve, whether it is able to achieve, or which played out in this statement that this guy is making right now. Like now, I told you that there were polls on social media that they were asked that, what do you think might win this stuff, or do you think might do that, or do you think might do this, right? And I find that some of those polls were real. So traditional media is beginning to die off, right? And I think anyone who is not taking advantage of the online media and relying solely on traditional media would be losing out its relevance in the coming ages.
So you said, well, I want you to understand something, and not just you, but the viewers, to understand that, yes, there's a difference between the data marketing, online marketing, and then the traditional marketing. Definitely, the difference are really clear. But does not mean traditional media doesn't still work. And for this instance, what we're talking about, it has to do with more of emotion, right? The product itself has to do with more emotion. So if this party A is less driven by emotion for people, then no matter what they do in terms of adverts, we don't still get to the heart of what? Of the people. And remember, it's not like the party A, the person in question, the candidate in question, didn't do online promotion. They also did online promotion. What?
Well, was it as visible as more than, was it more than the online?
Now you should know how this you should know how advertisement work online. Advertisement work online. This platform look for people who engage with such content. So if you engage with such content, they will look for similar people like you. So there's possibility that you would what get to engage, even though you see it, you might just see it once and you'll never see it again. But for people who engage with it, the system already knows, oh, these are the set of people that can engage with this kind of work. The content, and that's why they have this special ad category now, especially for Facebook advertisement, whereby they tend to categorize businesses that are into politics, housing, money, and I can't remember the last one. That's because they know the set of people that engage thoroughly on this kind of words, on this kind of issue. You understand? So another thing I would like to say, I just hope I haven't forgotten this, is that for the traditional media, we cannot rule out that traditional media is dead. It's not. For some businesses, it's actually bringing in revenue for them. I'll give you an example based on the example you said. You said the real estate firm. Now, for real estate companies, like here in Nigeria, for example, you find out that real estate invests, those big real estate companies, they invest in billboard ads. And these billboard ads actually what? Help people, help drive customers for them. And there's this mindset you should know. It's subconscious, it's psychological. Even the buyer itself might not be so aware of it. But any brand who gets to even put their billboard on certain location, in certain place, gives the client this notion of, oh, this brand is a big brand. This brand is a brand I can trust. You understand? And automatically what? They patronize from them. So most of this, if you watch it, many of them tend to what? Tend to still continuously do what? Billboard adverts. If it's not working for them, do you think they will continue doing that same billboard adverts? Now, I'm also going to bring it to, I think in the US, there's a place, I can't remember, is it Los Angeles, New York? Yeah, there's an area whereby so everywhere is covered with a billboard. I can't just remember.
New York City.
Their city is covered with what, billboard. And there they charge heavily. In short, there's no space. When I read an article or a video discussing how those billboards have been placed, sometimes you might wait for the next 1 year, 12 months. Someone would have taken one particular, at least one space for the next 2 years. You would have to, the competition is so tight. And they are like almost 50-100 in that place. So if they are 50-100, why are people still doing it? That's the question you ask. And don't forget that traditional media still doesn't just boil down to just the billboard we see. People coming down to sports, right? Whereby you see in stadiums, all those are the board side. I'm not the sport person. But those things that show the barricades in the field, right? Inside the field, yeah, those barricades. You see those ads. Some are screen, some are statics. They just stand alone. The shirts of artists are what? Also what? Adverts. So traditional media also still goes a long way, because if brands are not getting results for these things, then why are they still doing it? And don't forget that traditional media helps with two things. Most especially one thing, awareness for the brand. So when people are aware of the brand, then they can make findings of, oh, what's this brand all about? And then they really want to what? Take that final decision to what? Want to purchase. So I don't think traditional media is dead. I only think that traditional media would not pally up to digital marketing, basically the online world, the online space.
So I want to get understanding. You're saying that it's not dead, but it does not pally. When you say it does not pally up to, are you trying to say that it's not dead, but it does not measure up to the digital marketing?
Well, it's obvious that the digital marketing, the online space, would always have an edge over the traditional marketing. So traditional marketing is quite expensive, right? So it's not everyone that can afford it, right? So definitely that's why I said it cannot fade out. Like, people think it's going to fade out. It cannot fade out. In short, I was reading an article where at first they thought radio, if you know when people had this thought of radio was going to fade out.
Yeah.
But still, radio what stands, and radio is not going anywhere anytime soon. It's still here. But the only thing is that there's changes, there's more trend in the online. And another thing you should know is the offline too would be adapting some changes too in its own sector. So that's why I said traditional media cannot die.
Okay, it cannot die. But there's something that's coming to take over traditional media, which is the online.
Coming to it,
that is taking over, and when something is taking over, something else is gradually dying off, and that is traditional media. Something that is in the stage of dying off is what going to what is good, but which is already, which I've already said.
So, meaning there won't be traditional media again.
Well, not,
would you say you then you should stop watch? There won't be sales of TV.
I don't understand.
Why should you be buying TV? Now your TV doesn't have to also boil. Your TV doesn't boil down to just your own national TV, right? Your terrestrial TV, like your pay stations, what you subscribe, also TV. There you also watch, see ads. That is TV adverts. That is traditional media. So if you are paying for your DSTV, you will definitely see ads on your DSTV. So is that going to fade out? No. So traditional media can never fade out. So everyone should have some having this notion of traditional media is going to fade out, is dead. Yeah, I won't say it's dead as per se, but I would just say it doesn't pile up with data marketing or online marketing.
So there we have it, guys. Traditional marketing is not dead, but it's gradually dying off. But we'll continue the session with another meat and facts of digital marketing. and hope you stay cool and chillax. Bye.